June 4th, 2008. Hasini, my lady, my love, listen to my broken heart. Every time when I close my eyes, I see your face. I can't get you out of my head. I am going out of my mind. Darling, you are everything I need. Without you, I am lost. Without you, I am nothing. I can't live without you. To me, living without you is like death. These are the last words in my diary, because I am going to commit suicide today. Ever since Hasini has left me, my sadness knows no end. I couldn't digest the fact that she has gone. It was a great grief to me. I couldn't fill the empty space Hasini has left in me, no matter how I tried. I was broke, depressed, completely down. Finally decided to commit suicide. I took the poison. I opened my wallet. Hasini, my lady love, I really miss you so much. It was my parents' photo, just beside Hasini's photo. Until that moment, I never thought of my parents. When I saw them, I started longing for them, and I wanted to write a few last words for them. I opened my book. Some papers fall down from that book. Those papers were a report about my father's health. According to that report, my father was hospitalized last month. That time I was at my college in Hyderabad, and I don't know what happened to my father. I found the phone number of the doctor who treated my father. I wanted to know about my father's health condition, and I dialed that number.
Hello? Hello sir, can I speak to Dr. Chaudhary?
Yes, speaking.
Hello sir, this is Kishore, your patient Krishna Rao's son. I just want to know what happened to my father and why was he hospitalized last month. Please doc, no need to hide anything, just tell me the truth.
Actually your father has got heart attack last month. His condition is very critical. He needs to be operated. I asked him to arrange money for his operation. He said it was a huge amount for him. That's why he refused to go for the operation. At least he can try to prolong the time for the operation by being on medication with the little money he has. But he said he has to pay for your higher education.
Doctor was continuing and I was crying. I was always in dreams. I was always busy with my friends. I never had time to think of my old parents. I thought everything with my family was okay. My dad never let me know that he had got heart attack and was hospitalized. I started thinking, what happens to my parents if I die? It was very hard even to imagine. Doctor was continuing, but I couldn't dare to listen anymore. I just cut the phone. At that moment, I was desperate to leave. Exactly at that moment, I got a call. It was my mom. Hello, ma.
చిన్నా ఎక్కడున్నావురా? నీ గురించి మేము చాలా కంగారు పడుతున్నాం. నీకు అసలు ఏమైంది? నువ్వు ఎందుకు అలా ఉంటున్నావు? నిన్ను అలా చూస్తే మేము ఎలా బ్రతకగలం? నువ్వు ఇంటికి రా నాన్న, ఆకలి వేయడం లేదా? చిన్నా ఎందుకు ఏడుస్తున్నావురా? ఏమైంది చిన్నా? మాట్లాడు, మాట్లాడురా. హలో హలో చిన్నా, చిన్నా 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 చిన్నా
హలో చిన్నోడా, ఏమైందిరా? ఎందుకు గడిస్తున్నానమ్మా? నువ్వు ముందింటికి రారా నాన్న. హలో చిన్న, చిన్న హలో 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 మాట్లాడరా. హలో
డాడ్, యూ గేవ్ మీ సో మచ్, యూ గేవ్ మీ సో మచ్, సమ్టైమ్స్ ఈవెన్ ఎట్ యువర్ ఎక్స్పెన్స్. డాడ్, యు ఆర్ రెడీ టు రిస్క్ యువర్ ఓన్ లైఫ్ ఫర్ ద సేక్ ఆఫ్ మై ఎడ్యుకేషన్. యూ నెవర్ మైండెడ్ యువర్ ఓవర్ టైమింగ్స్ ఆన్ ద జాబ్ ఫర్ ద సేక్ ఆఫ్ మై కాలేజ్ ఫీ. వెన్ ఐ వాజ్ ఎ కిడ్, యూ టాట్ మీ వాకింగ్. But when you become old and paralyzed and unable to walk, I ran away from my responsibilities. I have never been your walking stick. When I was a kid, you were my superhero. Now I am grown up and started disregarding you. I forgot the fact that you have made me who I am. I am sorry that I have never been grateful to you, Dad. Mom, nobody is equal to you. Without you, there would be no me. Nobody loves me like you, no matter what I do. Mom, I often shouted on you, but you were patient when I am foolish. I made you cry deep inside your heart, but nothing was changed in your love. When I was ill, I still remember how you spent all your nights nursing me. I was always impatient when you needed me the most. I know how you try to hide your rolling tears and smile at me. Now you will be waiting for me outside of the home. But Mom, I'm not coming home. Mom, Dad, I have always disregarded your sacrifices, unselfishness and unconditional love. My heart is drenching with tears. Now I am regretting for my hasty decision to commit suicide. I am breathing heavy. My heart is throbbing. Now I am at the doorsteps of death. But now I want to live. I don't want to die when you need me the most. I just want to see you once, only once.
I thought I was dead, but I was lucky. Somebody has seen me when I was dying. They called to the emergency services. I was taken to the hospital just on time. I was born again. I didn't understand the value of life until I entered into the doorsteps of death. You may wonder whether I loved anyone ever after. Yes, I started loving my parents. I started loving myself.